Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life.
Yeah, amen.
He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet he shall live.
Yes, yes.
And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die.
Amen.
I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the later day upon the earth.
Yes.
And I shall see God, whom I shall see for myself.
Amen.
My eyes shall behold and not another. Amen. You know, we brought nothing in this world, and it is certain we can take nothing out.
Yes, yes.
The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Yes, yes.
Oh, we're going to have an invocation right now by Pastor Jeanette Hayes, and then a selection.
Your hands is moving.
y'all hear the song, it said he never fails.
Amen. Yeah.
Your God, is the Alpha and Omega.
Yeah.
Oh, he is the beginning and the end. Oh, he is the first and last. Oh, our God is awesome. Yeah. He never fails. He's God all by himself, and he needs no other. When you're out there and down and out in that midnight hour, look upon the hills from which cometh your help, and call upon your God. Don't doubt a phone. Put the phone down and call upon your God, for he will answer you. He knows what you need, before you even ask.
Yeah.
Oh, he ain't going to fail.
No.
During this time right now,
yeah.
God is lifting spirits.
Yeah.
Oh, he's changing lives. Yeah. Oh, he's in the midst of all this. You see, death is going to knock on our door, each and everybody's door.
Mm-hmm.
The question is, are you going to be ready?
Amen.
Are you going to be ready? Time is winding down.
Yes.
Time is winding down.
Amen.
Right then, we're going out of Old Testament by Reverend Billy Moore, and then after that, Reverend Ernest Martin. I will be doing the New Testament.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
God is good.
Yes, he is.
And all the time. On this occasion, and this may be a memorial, sir, but it's still a homegoing.
Amen.
Because, you know, we come together, and the Bible said that the joy of the Lord is our strength.
Yes.
And even in times of sorrow, we know that he's the one that brings us peace.
Yes.
So today, I just want to give honor to God, to my Lord and Savior Jesus, to my family.
Amen.
And thank you, Lord, for my family.
Yes.
And to Sister Paula.
Amen.
Paula was by riding the church buddy. So she would call and then said, well, I want to ride. I want to go with you tomorrow. I said, okay. So we would get up together and she would go. We talked about everything. We laughed together. We cried sometime together. We had a good time together. All things, you know, we all go through things, but the Lord himself said he would never leave us nor forsake us. So even in the midst of the times that trouble comes, y'all, we can depend on him.
Yes.
We might cannot can depend on each other, but we can depend on him.
Amen.
So we had a good time, and she enjoyed church. I know she did, because when we would leave and she'd get in the car and she would talk about it. She would tell me how she enjoyed it. She said, and our family being together. You know, because at one time, it was her and my sister Gloria and my sister Doris and my sister Pumpkin and my cousin Joyce and my cousin Peggy. And all of us was going to the same church. Sister Debbie would check in every now and then. She was going somewhere else. I'm not saying she was coming, but it was all of us cousins, and it had never happened before. And we was enjoying that. We loved it. And we would talk about it. She would say, Lord, if our mamas could see us right now.
Amen.
You know, us together serving the Lord. That was what it was about. But I'm not going to go on with that. But I just thank God for that. And we love Paula.
Amen.
Our church family love people that talk to her. When you sit down and talk, you know you're going to be talking to her. You might well accept it. But she was a person that, well, she would tell you like it was.
Yes.
And she didn't bite her tongue, but we also know that she had a sweet spirit about her as well. I love my family, all of us. We're family.
Yes.
You can choose your friends, but you can't choose your family.
Amen.
Family is God first, family second.
Amen.
Amen.
And I'm going to be reading from Psalms 121. I will lift up my eyes into the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not suffer thy foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee will not slumber. Behold, he that keepeth Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is thy keeper. The Lord is thy shade upon thy right hand. The sun shall not smite thee by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He shall preserve thy soul. The Lord shall preserve thy going out and thy coming in, from this time forth and even forevermore. May these words comfort you and keep you. And family, I want you to know, Teresa loved all of y'all, especially her sisters, brothers, nieces, nephews, in-laws. She talked about y'all all the time. So know that she loved y'all very much. And I love you as well. Be blessed.
Like Real Moore just said, Teresa loved her family. All she talked about was her mother, her siblings,
yes,
her aunts. Oh, she'd get on me all the time.
You ain't nobody but Uncle Ernest.
Yes.
She would. She loved her family.
Yes.
And she was about love. You know, God is about love.
Amen.
Ain't no hatred or evil in God.
Amen.
God is about love. And I, you know, I never forget it. And it, I was happy as it was. When my daughter died, I had been up for like a month. And I was laying in the bed just trying to sleep. And then somebody come and sat on the foot of the bed. And I looked up, it was Teresa. She done left, she was in the hospital. She done left the hospital. Teresa was in the hospital gown and burned her foot of it. I said, Teresa, what are you doing here? Just left the hospital. I don't know how she got to the house, but she was there.
Man.
She said, cuz ain't no way in the world that you are born and I'm not going to be by your side. And you tell me that about that. That's all. She was sick. She was in the hospital.
Yeah.
But I looked up and she at the foot of my bed with the hospital gown on and barefoot.
Yeah.
And you know, I think about the love and I want to read 1 Corinthians chapter 13.
Yes.
Love. Though I speak with the tongue of men and angels and have not love, I have become like a sounding brass or a tingling cymbal.
Yes.
And though I have the gift of prophecy and understanding all mystery and all knowledge, though I have all faith so I could remove mountains and have not love, I have not nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not love, it profit me nothing. Love suffer long. And is kind. Charity, love not. Love vaunteth not itself. It is not puffed up. It do not behave itself unseemly. Seeketh not her own. It is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. Rejoice not in iniquity, but rejoice in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hopeth all things, endure all things. Charity, love never fails. But whether there are prophecies, they shall fall. Whether there are tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part and prophesies in part, but when that which is perfect comes, then that which is in part shall be done away with. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put all those childish things away. For now we see through a glass darkly. But we're face to face now, I know in part, but then shall I know even as also I am known. And now abide in faith, hope, and love.
Yes.
These three. But the greatest of these three is love.
Amen.
And if I believe Sister Teresa could say anything, to all of us. She would say, if loving you is wrong, I don't want to be right.
Amen. Amen.
Right now, we will have family reflections. 2 minutes, please, if you can. You know, I know how the Holy Spirit works, you know. But Sister June wants to go last.
Yeah.
Family reflections.
I would like to say on Monday of the week of Teresa's passing, I went by and saw her. She was so happy. She called me. She wanted me to come by. She had spent the whole weekend with her first cousin Shirley. And she was telling me how Shirley just catered to her. She didn't have to do anything. She brought her breakfast to her. She done all this. And she was just so happy and amazed at how Shirley treated her that weekend. And she said, I had the best time. I said, Teresa, do you want to ride with me to Winston, to the mall? Because I had to take some stuff back. She said, no. She said, I am just so tired. She said, because me and Shirley had 2 days together, and I'm wore out, and now I'm going to relax. But she was so happy that she spent that weekend, and Shirley showed her all that love.
Amen. Amen.
I want to stand and say I love Teresa for 41 years.
Amen.
She's been my sister-in-law since then. And every day since she came to Jonesville, she called Ellis and I. And we talk and laugh and have fun. We talk and discuss some issues and we get hung up on. And you know how Teresa is.
Yes.
But then the next day she called and Ella said, I'm not mad. So they go talking again. So we'll miss those everyday calls. I've missed my sister-in-law for 41 years. She was good to me.
Amen.
We were good to each other. And we always had love.
Amen. Amen.
As my wife was saying, Hillary, Paula and I was close.
Amen.
Take your time.
Bless you, Lord.
It's all right.
Bless you,
Lord. We talk on a regular basis. Paula would talk to me. She'd tell me things. And, you know, we discussed things. Some things, you know, I didn't agree with, but she didn't agree with me.
Yeah.
But at the end of the conversation, we agreed with each other.
Mm-hmm.
And Paula could confide in me in anything. I'd tell her just like it was. You know?
Yeah.
I'd say, Paula, now you know you need to do this. Because I know none of us always been perfect.
No.
Amen.
But through Christ Jesus, we made perfect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We would talk. And, you know, I tell her the scriptures, she'd tell me, yeah, you're right, brother. She'd get mad and hang up, and she'd call me back. So, you know, I'm going to miss it. But I know what she's done, we all going to have to make one day.
Yes.
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 It's not guaranteed nobody will be here, but you know, we know who holds the keys to the future.
Yeah.
And we know if we go by the plan God has set for us, we can't go wrong.
Yeah.
It ain't gonna be good here on earth. Of course we shouldn't expect them to.
Amen.
When we get to heaven,
yeah,
we have a joyous time.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
And, you know, that's what it's all about. Some Paula, she's made a step we all gonna have to make one day.
Yes.
I just hope when we all make this step, that we all got a mindset on Jesus and a heart right.
Yes.
Because now is the time. He said, the day you hear my voice, harden not your heart.
Yes.
So, you know, we know Paul's in a good place and we have to.
Amen.
Yeah.
Just continue to pray for us, our strength, you know, my family, some of my sons that went through a few things. But they know who holds the keys to the future.
Yeah.
And that's what counts.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. I'd just like to say we don't miss Teresa.
she was at our home Thanksgiving and also Christmas with Shirley and the other children. And when she first come, I welcomed her into our home. And she was a good person. We all loved her. We got along good. And she's going to be missed. But I know she's at peace.
Yeah.
And she wouldn't want us to feel sorry because we know where she is.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen.
Well, for me, what I'm gonna miss out of this family, she's the only one I can call at 7:30 in the morning. Nobody else gets up early. So I'd call and she would ask me, what do you want so early? I said, hey, everybody else is asleep. And I would tell her when I moved here about a year and a half ago, hey, I'm gonna go such and such. You wanna go? That was my road butterfly. Whenever I went somewhere, she would get in the car and she would be telling me, when you go up this road, I said, look, you don't even drive. So just sit in the car and drive. So I'm definitely going to miss her. And she was a truth teller. She would tell me, look, I don't want to talk about this today. And she would hang up on you. But she'd call you back. And she said, hey, well, you know, yesterday was a good day. I said, okay, well, don't hang up with me today, because if you do, I don't want to hear from you. But that was truly my butterfly.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Amen.
I'm going to truly miss Teresa. You know, like Martha said, she was there at Thanksgiving and Christmas, and I took a picture of her Christmas, and me and Mom sit there, and just like her eyes was glowing. It was a beautiful picture. And like Debbie said, she stayed the New Year's with Shirley. But that Tuesday, she called me, on Tuesday night. And she called me twice. I said, what is it, T? All she talked about Tuesday was the Lord. She said, Ernest, I just want to get closer with the Lord. She said, I just want to elevate and take another step because I know he's got me. And that's all she talked about. And I told my mother and Debbie, you know, when they went and seen her, and she was in there Friday. I might have been the last person she talked to, but all she talked about was the Lord and getting closer to him. So be careful what you ask for. God will ask. Answer prayer.
Yes.
You just gotta be ready. You know, sometimes a lot of people be sick and people be like going there and praying for the healing. Nah, I ask the victim what they want. Some of them might tell you, I'm tired and I want to go on home. You know, we never know, you know. But it's like Teresa was telling me, you know, it's my time. You know, I didn't understand sometimes. You know, the Bible is a mystery. Sometimes we don't understand it, but all she talked about was getting closer to the Lord. Yeah. And trust me, she's close with the Lord right
Amen.
Now.
Amen. Amen.
She's, like Brother Ellis said, she's somewhere where we longing to go.
Mm-hmm.
We got to make it. In order, like Brother Ellis said, in order for us to make it, we got to change some things.
That's right.
We got to get some things right. We got to empty some old filthy stuff out of us. Well, it was back in 2021. We should have left that in 2020.
Mm-hmm.
This is 2022.
Mm-hmm.
Get a new grip on life. And if God ain't in your life, get God in your life.
Amen.
Get God in your life. I'm serious.
Amen.
Get a relationship with God. That's the best thing in the world, is a relationship with God.
Okay, we got this young lady, Faith.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
I've been listening to everyone's comments, and everything you all have said is so totally true about Paula. And we call her Paula. My name is Faith Nelson. I'm from Highland Springs, Virginia, right outside of Richmond. And I met Paula probably about 30 years ago. I mean, you just, you're gonna click with Paula, because she just, mm-hmm. one of those people that everybody gravitates to. And she made sure that, you know, she was able to have a conversation to whoever she wanted to have one with. So she helped out with some things that I was doing on the media ministry. That, but her, you know, she has so many talents. Mm-hmm. So she gravitated on to another ministry, the scholarship ministry, I believe it was what it was. And she did wonderful work there. And then after that, you know, she just kept trying to find her way. Then she went with the United Negro College Fund. And she loved doing it. She was awesome with that because she was a people person. She was one of those people that loved being around people, you know. And she could be silent and stay at home and be quiet if she wanted to. I mean, she was versatile, but she loved being around people. So sometimes when I was cooking, I said, Paula, come on over to the house. I'll come pick you up and, you know, cook and just let's eat. And I remember one time she was at the house, and this was a few years ago. It was me, my older sister, my husband. And we were just sitting at the kitchen table talking, and all of a sudden my husband started doing this dance. And if we all did not almost fall into the floor, I wish I could get them demonstrated to you, but I'm not gonna do that. But it was so funny. I mean, but she was just one of those people who loved being around. Just loved being around her. She was, and if she got mad, she would throw that arm up, cross those arms, and throw that leg up. You know, she had some words that even I couldn't put to poetry. I'm like, all right, Paul, just calm down. You know, but she would always tell me, she was like, Faith, you're the only sister that would, besides June, who would just give it to her straight. And she never hung the phone up on me. Wouldn't let her do that.
Me neither.
She ain't on June either. And she said, you always give it to me straight, and I just love you. She said, I just love you. So she did love love. She did love love, and she craved. She wanted it from every aspect of her life. Yes. She really did. And one thing she talked about all of you. So I know a lot about you guys. Over 30 years, and don't worry, stand with me. But I mean, she loved each and every one of you, just like they said. And she wanted so much for you all. And I think that's why she didn't concentrate so much on herself, because she was worried about you all. She wanted you all to just start doing the things that God wanted you to do. She knew what she had. She knew what she wasn't doing. But it didn't stop her from wanting more for you all. You know, so whatever gift you're sitting on, if you got a book inside of you, if you got a song inside of you, please get it out. Please get it out.
Amen.
Because the world, obviously, it is something you think about a lot. You know that's God.
Yes.
You know that's the Holy Spirit telling you. Amen. You got to do that. So you have to do that. Or you're going to go to your grave the same way she did, with some things that was inside of her. Mm-hmm. But one thing she did know the Lord. She studied and she read every day.
Yep.
She did that more than I did. Mm-hmm. And I know she did, because she would call me and we would talk about things. Mm-hmm. So I knew what she was doing. Mm-hmm. She loved her parents. She never got over their death.
No.
Never did. Mm-hmm. So when I found out she had passed, I was like, Lord, I'm going to miss her so much. But she's with her mom and her dad and her sisters, you know.
Yeah.
I was thankful for that.
Yeah.
But one thing, we'll take out this and then sit down. One thing we had in Richmond, we had a women's group. And it was usually at my girlfriend Joanne's house. And Joanne was the cook of this whole group, little bitty thing, little redhead. Mm-hmm. And a cook her behind her. I'm telling you, she could really cook. Still does. And we would just women from all different backgrounds. And we'd have some men there too. But this was a time that we could come together, and whatever issue you were dealing with at the time, I mean, you could air it out. Mm-hmm. You didn't have to air it out to the whole group, because it was just different people chattering, you know, around the whole house, really. And so you might have somebody there who was a counselor. And you might have just gone through a divorce or going through a divorce. And that person was there for you to talk to. You didn't ask for a person to talk to. That person just happened to come to you. Mm-hmm. It was all anointed. This is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. Yeah.
You may have been in the market looking for a house. There's a real estate broker sitting right there. Mm-hmm. You know, so we had different people from different backgrounds. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the day, you know, the wine was poured, the laughter went out, tears were shed, hugs were made. Mm-hmm. And that's what Paul wanted.
Yes.
And that's what she got. So I will hug her every day, and be thankful and grateful. for not loaning her to us during this time.
Amen.
So we know where she is.
Yeah.
She loved God.
Amen.
She loved God.
Amen.
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 Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
I'm not in the family, but I lived here in Jonesville. And I met Paula really a strange way. I had gone to the grocery store, and as I was leaving, she was sitting in front of the store. I got just about all the way home, and I know it was the Lord who told me to go back. To offer her a ride. And I went back and I said, I drove up beside her and I said, Paula, I didn't know her name. I'd never seen her before in life. And I said to her, I said, are you waiting for someone to take you home? She says, yes, I'm waiting for the ride. I said, come on, I'll give you a ride. And that day, we clicked. We could talk. We talked every other day, I guess, for the time that she was here. She would call me and we would talk. I knew all about her family. I knew about her father. I knew about her mother. I knew about her sisters and her brothers. She would always talk to me about her family. And just like I heard you said, she loved her family. She loved her mother. She talked about how her mother gave her so much and how her father, when he died, how she saw the building, the home that they were living in as it caught on fire. And I don't really think she ever got over that, because if you ever talk to her, as a matter of fact, she came to our church and she got up and she testified about how her father had died. And, you know, she came into my life at a time I believe God wanted her there, because we did share. We shared. She shared things with me and I shared things with her. And she would always tell me, she says, you know, Roxy, when I get up in the morning, I thank God every day that he lifted me up. And we would talk about the Lord, you know, and things that was going on in her life. And then she went to church with me for a while, and then she decided, because I was going to a church over in Elkin, and I would take her to church with me on Sundays, and sometimes on Wednesdays. And then she started wanting to go, I think she wanted to go where her family was. Where her family was going to church. So then she started going there. And just like she came into my life, she left out the same way. On the Monday that she died, she called me and she said, you know, Roxy, I want to tell you about my life, what I've been through, and all the things that I have suffered in life. She said, I'm going to tell it to you because I know you won't ever tell anybody. And I will never tell anyone what she told me that day. That was on a Monday, and she died, I think, that Tuesday. Okay? And after they called me and told me she died, I said, Lord, you know, she came into my life really, really estranged, and then I could not believe she had died after telling me all that she had told me. She talked to me for about an hour. And the whole time she was talking to me, I couldn't say a word. I just listened to her talk. Paula was a remarkable woman. Mm-hmm. She had a lot of wisdom. She was smart. And she loved her sister, June. she talked, every time I talked to her, she was talking about her sister, June. And if June told her something, that was the gospel. And I just thank God that she came into my life for the while that she was here. And I miss her. I miss her phone calls. She was just a, you know, she was just a sweet, and just like you said before, if she had something to tell you, you didn't have to go to listen to another neighbor to hear what she said. She would tell you what she had to tell you to your face. And I love that about her, because I'm basically the same way. If I have something to say, you will know it. And I love Paula for that, because that said that she was a true person. She was a person you could trust. So I thank and praise God today. But just being here with the family and meeting her sister and her brother, Elliot, and the rest of the family, and the sister that she told me she had a good time with on Christmas or Thanksgiving, one of those days. She said she spent that time, and she said, I had such a She told me that Monday, how much fun she had. And she really did enjoy you people. She loved her family. So I thank God for the time that I knew Paul.
Amen.
I want to just say that I remember Teresa. And I thought about my grandmother's house when think about her and Alice, you know, they spent a lot of summers with us.
We yes.
grew up together, you know. And we went out to visit them in West Virginia every now and then, but the most of the time they was her and Alice was down there in the summer. And I just thank God for her, knowing her. And the other church they told me is Mount Pleasant, that's where I go. And she would come and worship with us. And I just want to stand and let family know that. The things that growing up together, and because we still call each other cuz.
Yes.
And that's the word that you know we're cuz.
Yes.
And I just want to stand up and say that she was meant a lot to me.
Was at my granny's house, her auntie, and this tall, long-legged, beautiful creature walked in, and that was the first time I ever heard my name pronounced with an R in it. I've been calling all my life until Teresa came, and she turned me into Carla. She followed me through high school. She encouraged me through life. She told me how I could get money for school. I went a different route. Scenic route, I call it. But it wasn't because she didn't try.
Right? Yes, amen.
And even until death, she was still encouraging me and encouraging my children, my daughter, to do better, to be better. And I just like to say, she was a selfless person. And she did, she loved hard. And I will be forever grateful for the things that she instilled in me.
Amen.
Well, I'm just going to say one more thing. I'm not going to say anything else. I remember when Teresa used to come here as a young woman. She was a teenager. And we used to think she was the most beautiful. She would dress. Put on that stuff, and she'd come in, she'd be scrubbing. And she said, look, y'all, you know, me and my sister, Gloria, and all of us, we look around and we say, gosh, she is bad to the bone, you know, because she had that charisma. And I mean, she would date somebody in trouble, I ain't said no thing. But she would get ready, get dressed. We said, well, where's she going? Because, you know, we were a little teen bop. We know we didn't know nothing about dating and nothing. She said, I'm going on a date. And she would say his name and everything. We just adored her because she had that charisma. And it was just, that was just a memory that I've always had. And I always loved her because she was a dresser.
Yeah.
And we just had fun with it. They would come down in the summer, like Brother Junior said, and she would stay. But she would have that walk, and then and the guys, they eyes be popping out. She had it.
Going up, Joe.
Okay. Well, if there's nobody else, then I need to bring up the bat. Let's talk about the vets. One of the common things that I see that has happened in this memorial service for Paula is that everybody is talking about the goodness of the Lord. If you're not saved, make that commitment. Make it right. Because tomorrow is not promised to any of us.
Amen.
Go home today and not have our alarm clock go off tomorrow morning. So, on behalf of the Thomas family, I would like to thank everybody that has come to share your kindness of words. It means a lot to me, it means a lot to the Thomases, and I know some of them could not come, but we represent, and we have always been very tight. And I was talking to my son, and he said, well, Mom, he said, how many people? I said, oh, about 20, 25. I said, the majority of them are first cousins. He said, you have that many first cousins? Mm-hmm. I said, that's not even the tip of the iceberg. Mm-hmm. I said, I have a lot of first cousins. I said, we kind of like grew up together because of all the kids and everything. But it is just so great that you came to share your memories and your thoughts of my sister Paula Teresa. And Billy's not wrong. She modeled in Cleveland with Pat Cleveland. She modeled with Beverly Johnson. And she told us the story when she was in Cleveland. She said she was there with Pat Cleveland and Beverly Johnson. And then she was out there strutting her stuff. And the people in the audience did not know who Beverly Johnson was, basically. She hadn't gotten to that famous part yet. And they thought Paula was there. Paula said she hung with the best of them. And that's who Paula was. And because she was an English major, she was always real tweaked with her enunciation and pronunciation. And so she would correct you, that's not the right thing, but she enjoyed life. And what she shared is that the spirit that lived on the inside of her was who she was. Yes. And yes, she was not perfect, in which none of us are. Amen. She didn't dot every I, and she didn't cross every T.
Amen.
But who you saw and who you met in Paula was who she was.
Amen.
And we love her. We are going to miss her. And I'm just blessed to be here to share in this memorial service for Paula Teresa Thomas.
Amen.
And one of the things that lives with us forever is that all our cousins in North Carolina had nicknames for us. She was Teresa, and my middle name is Esther from the Bible. And all my cousins referred to me as June Esther.
Yes.
That's what I was always called. So then when I got older, it's like, just call me June. That's okay. Esther's a beautiful name, and I love it and everything, but June is okay. But it was just, that's who she was. And I want to thank you again for coming and sharing and speaking such great accolades to my sister Paula Teresa Thomas. She will be missed, and she was loved. And I never gave her the opportunity to hang up on me because I told her if she did, I would not call her back. I would have threatened not to. I would not call her back. I said, so you're going to talk with me. You may not like what I have to say. You're going to listen. And then when you finish, don't just hang up. Tell me, I'm gone now. And we talked, but I did not sugarcoat it. I told her what she may not wanted to hear. But she respected what I said.
Yes.
And I don't say anything where I'm not walking and walking and talking the talk. If I say it, I meant it.
Yeah.
If I'm walking, if I'm saying something, I'm talking about God, I meant it.
Yeah.
You know, I stand for truth. Because
Amen.
You should know the truth. And the truth shall and will
yeah.
set you
yeah.
free.
Yeah.
Amen.
So if you are not saved and you have no commitment, then you got 3 ministers here that will be willing to give you that down the Roman road, which is Romans 10, 9 and 10, where it talks about, you know, come, get saved, because I don't want anybody to leave this earth and not have the opportunity. And a lot of people look at this and they say, why do you want to give the invitation to discipleship at a funeral? Why not? Because there's people there that may be right at that door and just have not crossed. So whenever you get the opportunity, add
yes.
in children to God, as they have all exemplified, and Faith and other people, and my brother Alice, take the opportunity. The best thing that you can do is have that personal relationship
Amen.
With God.
Yes.
And so I just want to thank all of you all again, and what a blessing. And I know that the ones that are here are the ones that were supposed to be here.
Amen.
Amen. So we missed the other ones, and for whatever the reason, but thank you again, and I asked my cousin Ernest to be the MC. I asked my cousin Billy to be make sure she was on it. And then once I got to talk to Pastor Hayes, never met her, but it was a kindred spirit between her and
Amen.
Me. She's
yes.
my sister too. And Faith is my sister from another mother. She's like the other Thomas. It's not really a Thomas, but she's always been there. She was there for Louise. She's always been there for us, and it's just a link. It's a connection. So again, thank you, and we appreciate it. And the Thomases, we love you, we love all our cousins. We ain't got to be in your presence to not like you or to not love you, because we do love you.
Amen.
So again, thank you for everything, and that's all I wanted to say on behalf of Paula. And I'm not gonna cry, because I've already shed my tears. But if I were crying, it would be tears of joy, because we have no need to be sad, because she is definitely in a better place.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. And hallelujah. We are striving to get her.
Hallelujah.
So we can be in a better place.
Hallelujah.
So thank you all again for everything.
Yes.
Love you.
Love you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, God.
His music so much.
Okay.
but I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. And we do have hope in those that know the Lord, y'all.
Amen.
So when we leave this earthly body, we're going to a tabernacle, not made by hands. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. Even so them also which sleep in Jesus, God will bring with them. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain until the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore, comfort one another with these words, the word of God for the people.
Praise Amen. To God.
May we pray. May the work I've done speak for me.
Yes, yes.
May the work that I've done speak for me.
Yes.
When I stand before my God, I want to hear him say, well done.
Yes. Hallelujah.
May the work I've done speak for me. Truly the work that Teresa has done has spoken to us today. Out of the mouths of all who we have heard and all who are present. Lord, one day that day will be ours, Lord God. And we truly want to hear you say, well done.
Yeah.
And welcome home.
Yeah.
So Lord, we just ask blessings upon all of us who are here with the families that we represent, because none of us are leaving the same way that we have come.
Amen.
So Lord, hallelujah. Again, the cry goes out that there's someone,
yes,
hallelujah,
Lord.
Jesus is calling on you right now. Don't hesitate.
Jesus.
Don't hesitate. Or tomorrow might be too late. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Lord, we thank you for how you've worked with all of us.
Yes.
We thank you how you've touched all of us. Mm-hmm. Now as we go, hallelujah, continue to work in our lives so someone may not see us, but see you in us.
Yes.
Yeah.
And come crying, what must I do to have some of what you got?
Yes.
Yes.
And Lord, give us the courage to say your name.
Yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
In Jesus' holy name.
Yes.
In
Jesus' holy
name. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. For as much as it hath pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world unto himself the soul of our sister, Paula Teresa Thomas. Wherefore we commit her body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust.
Yes.
For we come into this world with nothing, and surely we can take nothing out.
Amen.
The Lord giveth, and the Lord taketh away.
Amen.
Blessed be the name of the Lord. In Jesus we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Let me forward to our God. On behalf of Spencer's staff and management, I'm sure the entire Thompson family will have us echo their sincere gratitude and thank you for each act and kindness that has been done during this time. For your calls, your visits, and most definitely for your prayers, for whatever part that you have played during this time. A special thank you to Reverend Martin, Pastor Hayes, and also to Minister Moore. Or anyone else that has participated in this service. And once again, they will have us to say thank you, and may God continue to bless you and have a smile upon you. And at this time, we ask everyone to stand, except for their family. And then, as they stand, everyone, if he would lead the family out, and we will go out into the parking lot. We want to do our final flight. We don't want to cut anyone short. But this time we ask the family to stand also and ask the members to lead us up.
I'm not Eddie.
But anyway, this is something on behalf of Spencer's funeral staff and management that we do to encourage the family to look up and to let go. But first of all, we have to look up. If we look up to God, God will give us that strength to let go. God will never leave us, nor will he forsake us. He even begins to say that he is our bridge over troubled waters. Paul began to go through the troubled waters. God began to breathe so that you could cross over the troubled waters until the other side to what you have. To what he needed to be. All the good things that were said about her, and she would probably look at us all out here today and say, may I go if you think the time is right. No more weary days. I live my life on earth below, and what a good example I tried to be. But now it's time to say goodbye, to set my spirit free. Paul and Paula go a little bit farther and say, I'm free. Yes. No more chains is now holding.
Hallelujah. Yes.
My soul is now rich.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.